Hi, this is attorney Stewart Guss, legal correspondent for Positively Houston. I'm here today with Dr. Jon Taylor of the University of St. Thomas. We're talking to Dr. Taylor today about some proposed changes to the Texas Constitution. If I could start, Dr. Taylor, by asking you a little bit about your background and your position here at the university.
I'm chair of political science, University of St. Thomas, PhD from Oklahoma. Don't hold against me, Texas people. I've been chair of poli-sci for over 10 years and been at UST for 16.
Okay, well, even though I went to UT, I'll try not to hold the Oklahoma thing against you.
Thank you.
One of the things that our viewers may not be aware of is that over the years, we often see changes to the Texas Constitution, much more than the U.S. Constitution. Can you explain to the viewers why?
Well, much more so. Part of it is because Texas Constitution is easier to amend, unlike the U.S. Constitution. And in particular, it's the legislature, for the most part, that does the amending, not the people. Although you and I could do it, it's a very rigorous process to get there. So instead, what happens is you have concurrent joint resolution that's proposed by a state rep, state senator, and many times it's either proprietary or it's some potentially some major policy change. But in general, we end up with anywhere between 8 to 15 amendments any given election cycle because we amend this thing so much.
And you mentioned to me when we were chatting that we're actually still operating on the 1876 Constitution, and we haven't talked about change for 40 years. Is that correct?
That's correct. We've not had a constitutional convention for 40 years, 74, 75 in that period. The Constitution actually requires that we at least consider it every 20 years, which we haven't done. It's been amended 474 times. We propose almost 650 amendments. It's just a system that perhaps needs to be seriously rethought.
Well, until we have a chance to do that, on this ballot cycle, we have, I believe it's 9 proposed constitutional amendments. There are a couple of them that you found particularly interesting or controversial. Sure. I was wondering if you could discuss them with us.
You bet. Proposition 5 and Proposition 6 are probably the ones that are going to get most people's attention that are actually going to bother the vote on November 5th. Sadly, I don't think we're going to get a large turnout statewide. Proposition 5 is the one that deals with reverse mortgages. Now, in the past, Texas legislature has been really reticent in giving at least elderly homeowners over the age of 62 the possibility of doing a reverse mortgage, concerns about homesteads, about losing their property, about being possibly, you know, just basically ripped off. The provision in Proposition 5 actually protects those homeowners by, among other things, requiring that the federal government, the FHA, actually does counseling with them and actually goes through a process to make sure that they understand what the steps are regarding reverse mortgage.
Okay, and then briefly, if you could tell us about the other proposition, the one dealing with the rainy day fund.
Proposition 6 is probably the most controversial, simply put, because it takes, some would say raids, $2 billion from the Texas, basically our rainy day fund. The concern about the rainy day fund is that it's there for a reason, a rainy day, and that the legislature basically kicked the can down the road to the voters rather than taking care of the problem themselves regarding water issues. Texas faces serious water issues already, and in fact, in the next 10 to 20 years, if we don't get a handle on water issues, particularly in central and northern Texas, we're talking about major economic impacts.
So these constitutional amendments can have serious impact on you, viewers. Do us all a favor. Let's go out and do some research, do our homework, get out there, and vote your conscience. Thanks very much. On behalf of Positively Houston, we appreciate your coming here today.
Thank you.